We faced a virus all on our own. A virus of hate, loneliness, blame and ignorance, dealing with uneducated, monstrous, despicable people every day. I'm not just talking about the virus, I'm talking about contracting HIV and it turning into AIDS, by the way. We are called queer, homo, dyke, diseased, infectious, perverted. And that's only a few of them. Don't even get me started on what they're to say to the wives and the husbands. We fought to be ourselves, we hid, we laid low, we separated ourselves into our own bars and clubs. We punched, stabbed, murdered all over the world, not only in Belfast, Nigeria as well. They are left to rot in cells and die alone, all because of contracting an STD for having sex. Yes! For having sex, something that is completely normal. We fight not to be criminalised. We fought not to be seen as a disease. We fight to not think that drinking battery acid might save ourselves from this world. We fight to not be a positive test result waiting to happen. We fight to be ourselves. And not everyone can relate to that. We fight to kiss. We fight to hold hands. We fight to even look across the room at another person. You know the look I'm on about. You see, our books are burned. That's if anyone writes about us. No songs about broken-hearted gays. No stories about two wives or two husbands. There's no stories about the woman leaving for another mum. In fact, there's no stories about gay people, full stop. We're gay. And we're beautifully gay. I don't hide who I am, nor do I live in a fucking wardrobe. I'm not your gay best friend. I am your best friend. And I'm not an accessory that I shout yes to every time you see me when I come into a room. I'm a human. A breathing, living human. I hope one day we don't come out. I hope it will be, oh, this is my partner, not, oh my god, what? You're gay. Parents will welcome their sons, daughters as they come. People will naturally understand because we aren't here to be understood. We're the doctors, politicians, the artists. We're the people in front of you. I'm not bitter, filled with hate, or even angry. I wear a smile on my face because I'm one of the lucky ones. We're gay. And we are beautifully gay.
Ba 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 Right, mods and rockers, punks and skinheads, they're all cults that have probably caused World War III in most homes at some time or other.
Thank you. avoided everyone I disagreed with. I'd avoid my own mother.
Today and tomorrow, what position would the Protestants be in?
For all of you here today.
I mean, this is hugely significant. It has been a long time coming, and it has been a very difficult struggle to bring Northern Ireland's abortion laws in line with human rights.
Hand in hand, now officially wife and wife, having walked down the aisle and into the history books.
We are equal to a man and a woman. Our love is just the same. It's no different. Sometimes, like, people may try and say it's not. It's our love is.
It is a victory for women's rights, and I'm sure some people will celebrate, but for us and for what we've been through, this is something which just had to be done. And I think that at midnight tonight we'll just be feeling glad that this period of barbarism and cruelty against women and young girls is over.
People who voted for me came together from right across the community, regardless of unionism, regardless of nationalism, regardless of all those labels. They came together behind Alliance to send a message.
Over the last week have been as depressing as they are disgraceful. Whilst not all of those involved are young, it has been particularly disturbing to see another generation of young people, of children, some as young as 12 or 13, involved in violent confrontation with the police. However, my horror at that has been intensified as I watched adults old enough to be their parents, old enough to know better, standing by cheering and goading and encouraging young people on as they wreaked havoc in their own community. This is nothing short of child abuse.
Amongst the various streets of Belfast, there's a street called North Street. To some, an insignificant street with a bland name. Yet to me, it's a place that holds a silly number of memories. It's exceptional, really, because it was the best of times during the worst of times. Sorry. Anyway, North Street. I worked at Curtis Shoes. You knew Curtis Shoes was there because you could smell the polyester from miles away before you even entered the shop. Amongst the confetti and the smell of polyester, Belfast threw a divide. Residue from hatred and Curtis Shoes. After working all day, I enjoyed the confetti Belfast also threw. Drinking, moving from bar to bar, drinks were flowing, music's going. And then shite. Divide came and reminded us all we had to go home. Stumbling round, the corner gates were closed. Past curfew, complete lockdown. And all I could think of is how the fuck am I going to get home? The police weren't there, luckily. So what did I do? Climbed the barbed wire gate, of course, because that's the most sensible thing to do. It wasn't easy being blocked out your head. Well, a bit tipsy. It was a different kind of trouble we faced then, compared to other teens. But I don't ever remember living in trouble. Amongst the chaos, there was sarcasm, laughter and drinks. Belfast moved on, but the Belfast mentality never moves on.